Thank you, but can I please see your wife?
By the way, Daddy, I think it's time that you need to inform him about the miscarriage.
The Divorce Club is brought to you by Revin Zambia, a taste of Africa.
Chirpy, what flavor is your crazy? Revin Zambia, the taste of Africa.
A Kazadi Films original.
It's not an easy thing, but I believe, as a man of God, as your mom has said, we've been with your wife, Sister Nelly, we've been with her for more than, this is 3 months now, but it's unfortunate. She went through a miscarriage. You both lost the child. It's so unfortunate that Brother Joshua had to hear about this sad news in such a manner. Not in a bad way, you know. The Bible puts it very clear in Romans chapter 9, verse 20. It says that, can a thing that has been made complain on how it has been made? If the owner has made it that way, who has got the right to complain against God or to ask God, why have you done this in this manner? The onus remains on God. He's the one who's got the answer. We are all here waiting. We'll be explained to when we get to heaven what transpired for the Madame to Joshua to have a miscarriage. Take heart. God has his own way of doing things. You know, God, with God, anything is possible.
But my wife had a miscarriage.
This is what I'm trying to explain to you, Joshua.
And you haven't told me anything.
Please take heart.
What kind of a father are you?
Take heart, Brother Joshua. I'm a man of God.
This is so hard to understand. Joshua should really know to say that for everything that happens, it has a consequence. Otherwise, that woman wouldn't have even gone through the miscarriage. It's because of his behavior, because he was trying to beat the wife. So for the reasons that he has been doing all these things, this might have been the cause. And besides that, he goes to start talking bad about the pastor, his prophet, and he knows how that man talks to God. If only he can come up with his faith the way he's been in the past, and through what prophet does by speaking to the Almighty, his God, things might be well with him.
What kind of a father are you? My wife had a miscarriage all this time. I've been calling, trying to find out.
I was just trying to protect you, Joshua.
Protect you from what? From what? Don't touch me. From what?
Joshua, your wife, it's because of the same issues what? That you've been going through.
Wait, what do you mean the same issues that we've been going through?
No, don't worry, Joshua.
Who knows what even caused that miscarriage? You know
it
how
is
long
well.
I wanted for the child.
It is well, Joshua.
Do you know what you're talking about?
It is well, Joshua.
So many plans for that child.
Joshua, do not let your anger be kindled like that. Joshua,
let me go.
God has got his own way
let me
of
go.
Doing things.
I'm telling you, I'm asking you to let me go, please. Where's my wife?
On that one, even me as a prayer warrior, as a man of God, you know, when that thing happened, I was in a shock. I was still praying to God. You know, it's not easy where you are seeing your son in the ministry passing through such a challenge. You understand, that is a very big challenge. I just didn't know how to break it out to him, how to let him know that this is what has happened. And I was praying, and I believe the way God does things in his own, in the spirit, I believe that it had to come out at such a time as this.
Where's my wife? Where is she now?
I've been trying to protect him because of the same habits of, you can see he's under anger. You understand? There's a spirit of anger so overwhelming on him.
But why can't he see his wife?
No, he can't do that for now. I've told the mother here to make sure that they keep a distance for now.
Is it pain for you right now? Are you pain for you? Do you know what you've done?
Joshua.
Do you know what you've done?
Brother Joshua, please.
Let me go. Tell them to let me go.
He's unruly right now.
Tell me what is my wife? Where's my wife? I just want to see my wife. Let me go. I just want to see my wife.
Guys.
Tell me where my wife is.
Guys.
Let him go.
It is well.
Joshua,
It is well. It is well.
Pastor, we need to know. Is his wife okay?
No, the wife is okay. The wife actually.
Why can't he see his wife?
No, for now, those are the conditions that we've put as a man of God.
Man of God, you just told him his pregnant wife is having a miscarriage. Surely he has the right to see his wife. Surely.
I know you cannot understand these things. These things are things of the spirit. I am a prophet.
I don't understand, but surely the man has the right to see his wife.
No.
Please.
He can have the right to see the wife, but I am the prophet. I'm the spiritual father.
Pastor
Kabasso,
in
very clearly, I said that you should never allow Brother Joshua to see Sister Nelly for the time being, not until God answers me. You cannot see, you cannot contain to see the wife. The wife, she's right outside.
I think better come down.
She's right outside, parked in the car.
No, just
please open this door.
Africa is different. Africa has great sound. Africa has great flavors. Africa has great taste. Drink chirpy apple, orange, grape, lemon, and pineapple. Chirpy, what flavor is your crazy? A product of Revin Zambia, the taste of Africa.
And you know what? Not in a bad way. You know, this has already grieved the spirit of God. You know, you might attract a curse. This is not a simple matter. Only God will vindict me.
But I don't understand. What gives you the right to take a man's wife away from him? Where's how? What gave you the right to do that?
No, the scripture is so clear. When you go to Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1, it talks about children to obey their parents, meaning that I am a spiritual parent to Brother Joshua.
What about his real parents? His earthly parents?
This is a spiritual matter. This is a spiritual matter. That is why they brought it to church.
If they knew that their
physical, their biological parents would handle it, they would have taken it to their home, to their parents.
Prophet, I don't mean...
Don't you touch me!
Prophet, I don't mean to be disrespectful, but this is a grown man who really cares and misses his wife. I don't understand how you can justify not letting someone see their wife. That's unjustifiable.
The spiritual aspect of this matter You know, a carnal man cannot perceive it, cannot understand.
This is a fake prophet, right?
You understand?
You must see about you.
Relax.
I know you. I know what you've done. Now, expose them, tell me.
Easy, brothers. Brothers, take it easy.
My wife away. Why is he keeping my wife?
The Bible is very clear.
Okay, excuse me.
The Bible says.
You allow him to do such things?
The Bible says in Romans 13.
I want my wife.
That everyone should be submitted.
Can you calm down?
Rumor has it there's a new girl in town.
You see that new babe in house 11?
My name's Scarlett, and these are my secrets. Get out of my neighborhood.
The Bible is very clear. It says respect
the
authority.
Right?
For there is no authority.
Except from God.
Take it easy.
Excuse me, sir.
Take it easy.
Excuse me, sir.
Brother.
May I talk to you, please?
Brother, these are the authority. You understand? The Bible says respect the authority. If there is no authority except from God, leave them.
Don't worry.
I have no problem by Brother Joshua bringing in the police. You know, I'm a man of the Word of God. I believe what the Word of God says in Romans 13. Let everyone be subject to the governing authority. You know, for there is no authority except from God. So I believe that if the authority has involved the authority, let them take their law, their role, let them play their role. I'm here to comply. I'm a law-abiding citizen. Don't worry, it is well. God is in control.
My brother, it's okay. We sorted out that office. Don't worry.
Why is he hurting my wife?
Don't worry.
Why is he hurting my wife?
Don't worry. Let's talk from the office. God is in
this
control.
This man has to work.
Don't worry. God is in control. God is in control. The God who called me will vindicate me.
Zambia.
Sir, do you know that what you are doing is wrong?
No. How can it be wrong?
What you are doing is wrong.
How can it be wrong?
How can it be wrong?
That lady that you are holding on to, she's mad. Don't you know?
I am their pastor. I'm a prophet, by the way.
So
I speak to God. God is the one who gives
you the right to hold on to somebody's wife.
No, I'm not really holding on to her.
You are doing
it's because of the challenges that they have been doing. No.
Where's
my wife? Let her come in. Mommy, you can come here. You can come
right now and right now. Could you go and bring that girl here?
Who's there?
No,
and you let her go back to the husband.
I can't do that.
You can't do that.
I can't do that. I'm still praying over
you. As you are praying, what you need is you continue praying, but you release that girl, let her go back to the husband. Because they're still married.
You know, I'm a prophet, and I am spiritual father.
So let's not talk about spiritual here.
That is why you cannot understand.
So you cannot understand.
I am a man of God.
You are a man of God, yes, and we are police officers. So you release that girl now.
With the policemen here, I don't think it
works
like that. It's
becoming
complicated.
It's easy.
That's what I can do. I understand.
Officer, at least tell him. Ask him, where's my wife?
Where's my protocol? Sister Nelly, right now, she's downstairs.
You
left her because there was a condition that I'd put.
You call her to come here. Forget about that condition. But you call her to come here.
Go and get Sister Nelly. Bring her up.
Cancel it.
No. Officer, I'm a man of God.
No, what interest do you have in that girl?
No, there's no interest.
So can you release that girl? Let her go back to the husband.
This is so hard to understand because we're also trying to protect this. But Joshua should always understand to say for everything that happens, it has a consequence.
All my pastors are holding on to my wife.
This is a spiritual matter. You cannot understand it. These people cannot talk in here. Can you please maybe excuse them so they can have their privacy? No. It is not right. These are spiritual.
You can never understand
these things. You can never understand. These are spiritual matters.
Pastor, Pastor.
I'm asking Pastor, you to allow them, just allow them to go out. Let them just go somewhere. No, let them go somewhere and have their privacy. These people haven't seen them so each other in a long time.
Because of you.
No.
Because
it's not really because of me. I follow what God instructs me to do. Mr. Producer, please. You know, I've agreed that they can speak to each other, but not in this manner. Not in this manner whereby there are people all over. Grant me just one wish. I'm asking you, Mr. Producer, if you can only grant me one wish that they can go out and speak in their privacy, that will make me happy, because there are consequences in this matter. This is not a carnal matter. It is a spiritual matter. And I, as a pastor, I'm still praying over this matter.
I'm a true man of God.
What true man?
What are you saying?
What are you saying? Nelly, what are you saying? What are you saying? Please, what are you saying?
I'm so sorry for breaking
your heart. I am respecting you.
Yes,
I respect the office.
Let me go.
This man here.
What role does the church, or should the church, play in a married couple's personal affairs?
As Zambians learn to separate sins from crimes, when it's a crime, report it to the police.
But generally, the church is doing more good than damage.
Which good? You know, like they encourage gender-based violence.
These churches, please close them.
The Catholics basically prepare
the
you.
The Catholics, from where there's a lot of sexual violence that happens to nuns.
You won't hear the end of life, Anne.
Let me go.
This man here. Mr. Producer, it is an abomination that Nelly can come in the presence of people and accuse me of sleeping with her as a full of grace man of God. You know, I spend most of my time in the presence of God, and just to stoop so low so that I can go down and sleep with her, it is unacceptable. And you know what? Not in a bad way. You know, this has already grieved the Spirit of God. You know, you might attract a curse. This is not a simple matter. Only God will vindict me. The God who called me, he's a God who will vindict me.
I'm so disappointed with Nelly, the way she's coming up with these stories. And you can imagine, you people, Nelly is a person that we have kept in our house. And I see no reason why she can speak ill about Prophet. Prophet Kabaso is a good man. Prophet Kabaso really believes in God. And when he speaks, he really connects to what God tells him. You can see even in church, there are a lot of scandals that are coming in. One after the other, it is Prophet Kabaso. One after the other, it is Prophet Kabaso. If really these things have been happening, I believe people should have been coming to me to tell me about the same. Even in the event that Nelly, our own daughter that I've seen growing in our own home, failed to tell me the truth, which means all these are just lies.
Calm down, brother. You're my mom, Zadida. Huh? Proprio, what's only happening because of the end?
He said, I thought because God told him, so I thought it was all right, it was okay. I know people will judge me, but the truth is I really love my husband and I want to make things right. I really love my husband, that's the truth. And I want us to be together, to be happy.
Messi, na 19 years in a bad luck chipata. So kuno kulusaka na kanisa kwa 7 years. Chifukwa chako wa madama wanabo wa nitengako. Tinkazwa 7 zera panyumba. Nikazwa piangira. Nikazume kungashua vonse panyumba. Vili buwini. Patiba madama kuma pesika panyumba. Sini pesika na weve. Pesika na wamuna wawa kachuka kunchito. Nima chisira, nima pikira, ni chita vonse panyumba mshemushi. So chifuka chakutu wa madam, so mapezika panyumba. Babosi kumangala, mamuna baba mene kumangala, batemba ma movies ya jama fiumu ya mene yovula. Bambo ni gwira gwira, so wanaboba ni tana, tinka penge kurumu one day. Peza watamba ma fiumu ya mene yaja. So palasi, kunapuka peze kati. Banuza tuwazani paya ngatisinza chita vamene bafuna kutiweve nchite. So ni nantu nabona hedinga oni kushita vamene wezo funa weve. Wakazi wahu kuna libe. So ni china buwela kuna ncha kutinifuna nikabeva zona. Nibauze. Na ibenji lali yonse wa uzilamu. So ino ndio wea nene afuna kutimu ntandize wauza vazona. Because when she traveled to Bambini Maning, the singer came and came. If no, come back ever soon.
The Divorce Club is brought to you by Revin Zambia, a taste of Africa.
Flavor is your crazy. Revin Zambia, the taste of Africa.
A Kazadi Films original.